Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the introduction to the We Are I podcast. What is We Are I all about, and where did We Are I get its name? These are some of the questions that people keep asking me that I talk to about this podcast on a regular basis about. And, you know, We Are I is complex and simple. It's a lot of meat and potatoes to it, and, you know, it's as clear as a glass of water. So, you know, as we go through this introduction and explain a little bit more about what We Are I is all about, I hope that everybody gets a sense that it's truly an information source for people to be able to connect with, and they may connect with it on, you know, days like today. They may not connect with it tomorrow, and it might be a tool that people use to be able to live their lives, their quality lives in any facet. So let's kind of dive into the name first and foremost, We Are I, and what does this mean? So We Are I sounds like it has to do with a singular I, but it actually doesn't. The I in We Are I stands for all of us. The we, same thing. It's all of us as well. Some days we're a we, and some days we are an I. And, you know, we don't know how we motivate other people in our communities, but people will leverage us for motivation, and they'll leverage us for inspiration, and we'll never even know. And there's a lot of people in my life that I gain inspiration and motivation from that probably have absolutely no idea. And one of these people, ironically, in my life has nothing to do with fitness, but I leverage this story that he told me all the time. This gentleman, his name is Francis, and he's my barber. And his story has to do with his journey to come over to Canada and the United States and what his family went through to get here. Francis and his family, they originally started off in Iran, born and raised in Iran. You know, most likely thought he'd probably never move out when he was a young man. And, you know, his parents one day said that they're going to start the process to be able to make their way to North America. You know, so Francis has quite a few siblings, and, you know, his mom and his dad, they all picked up, and they moved from Iran to Syria because it's one of the gateways to be able to get to Canada and the United States. And along the way, when they were in Syria, Francis's father got killed. You know, and as he's telling me this story, you know, I was thinking, I can't even imagine what it would be like uprooting an entire family and just making this incredible journey, you know, from Iran to Syria, and then who knows where else from there, to eventually end up in a place that you think is better, that you don't even really know if it truly is. You know, and after Francis's father got killed, I'm sure that it was extremely tough for them, but it never deterred them. And it's not even like they all could come to Canada and the United States all at one time, or even together. You know, Francis, he continues and tells me this story about how, you know, one sibling would come over, establish some roots, you know, work, build up some money, send some money back. You know, then another sibling would come over, and just with our immigration laws, they wouldn't end up in the same city or the same state or province or even the same country. But they were so determined to be able to seek out this better life that it didn't stop them. You know, so over the course of all these years, you know, another sibling comes over, and then another sibling comes over, and eventually they all bring their mom over. You know, and as Francis is telling me this story, like, you can tell there's not even one sad part about it. You know, his father dies, and, you know, his siblings are spread all over the place. They had to leave their mom in Syria for who knows how many years, and it's not sad, not even angry. You know, not disappointed, nothing, just happy, just authentically happy. You know, so I asked him, I was like, Francis, how are you still happy, you know, when things went seemingly so sideways? You know, and he says, Blake, look, I have my own business. I'm doing great. You know, my uncle's sitting right next to me, you know, running the shop. He's like, I couldn't ask for anything better. He's like, I know my family, they're healthy, they're happy, they're in a better place, and that's all that matters. You know, I was like, that's some true life perspective. You know, that's perspective from people who they've been through real adversity, and not some of the fake adversity that we create today and the drama that we create in our daily lives now that doesn't belong there and should never exist, but you know, we create it anyway. Like, this man went through authentic adversity with his family and is happy. You know, and appreciates what he has. You know, so I look at this and, you know, how I live my life, whether I'm working out or I'm at work or I'm with my kids, or, you know, I leverage stories like that, you know, and I've never even told him that. You know, and there's lots of independent stories like that in my life with people that I meet all the time where, you know, there's a mom who comes into the club. She's got five young kids, you know, gets up at 4:45 every morning to be able to come get her workout in before the kids get up. You know, then crushes the morning, gets them all to school, gets everything organized at home, goes picks them up from school, driving them to all their activities. You know, and then even has the time at the end of the day to come back to classes with her oldest daughter in the evening to be able to connect with her. You know, that's amazing to me. I leverage stories like that to be able to get me through my days. You know, the 5:30 in the morning classes that we have here, you know, Antonio's a great instructor. And when I'm sitting here in the morning getting my work done and I see these 14, 15, 16-year-old kids getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning to be able to come down to the club, to be able to get in a workout in at 5:30 in the morning, that's inspirational. And when I was that young, the last thing that I was thinking about was working out first thing in the morning when I got up, never mind getting up at 5 a.m. to do it. So that's a little bit about the we are I, you know, so in all those examples, I was a we, because I'm pulling inspiration from all those other people who are I's. You know, and there'll be things that I do in my day that makes me an I to people who then are we's. So we are I is about taking individuals off the pedestal and putting everybody on the pedestal, because that's where we all should be. There are no true singular outliers in life. We're all outliers. We just need to be able to live our lives in peace. We need to be able to live our lives finding things that we find exciting and fun and that make us happy. And when we're living happy, authentic lives, we are naturally going to be eyes to other people. Some of the things that we'll be discussing on this podcast too are local innovations to BC. So BC is a province that has a tremendous amount of innovation when it comes to health and wellness. We have an abundance amount of products that are coming to market or are in market right now. A classic example of one of those products that's extremely successful is the Vega brand. You know, Vega brand was born and raised in BC and is now a multi-billion dollar company. We're going to be talking to a lot of smaller companies, more on the startup side, you know, to really learn their stories about how they started these companies, why they started these companies. Because the one thing that I've learned with talking to some of these owners is there's usually an amazing story behind it. You know, most people didn't start these companies just to have a bar or have a drink just simply because they wanted to start a business. A lot of these people, you know, they had a sports injury or a family member was sick, and it inspired them to be able to create a product that they didn't think was on market or in market right now that could truly be beneficial to recovery, reducing inflammation, just living a healthier life in general. And these stories are extremely inspirational. You know, so again, it's a way to be able to pull inspiration from people, you know, to live your everyday life. But, you know, maybe these interviews will help people, you know, or be inspired to make a product themselves that can not only help them, but will help many other people as well. We're going to be talking to a woman who started a company where they make hamburger patties out of cauliflower, so taking the meat right out of it, a vegan option. We're going to be talking to a local kombucha startup, a local health and wellness bar from a man in North Vancouver. And just really, you know, hear these great backstories behind these products so that when you walk into a store and you see them on the shelves, that you have a little bit of the story behind it when you're picking it up and you're eating it or drinking it. We're also going to be talking to a lot of doctors, GPs, specialists, and mental health specialists to really truly understand the movement. How many people are out there right now who want change that aren't just regular everyday citizens like you and I? over the course of the years that I've been in the health and fitness industry, and especially within the last year, I've talked to a lot of GPs, a lot of specialists, and a lot of people in the mental health field that authentically want change. They want big pharma, you know, out of our healthcare system. You're not saying there's no place for big pharma, but there just definitely is not the predominant role that what big pharma plays in our lives today. They understand there needs to be a change where there's more life coaches being prescribed, you know, looking at people's diets, you know, understanding how people's nutrition really affects their overall life from a physical and a mental health standpoint. So there's a lot of people out there that want change. There's a lot of barriers that you may or may not be aware of that are really inhibiting that change. And the one thing that I want to do through this podcast is give these GPs and these specialists and these healthcare providers a voice so that everybody understands that there is a movement coming and there is a movement for change. And we all need a voice to be able to go to our local and provincial and federal governments and say, hey, you know, we need to change something, and we need to change something fast. And I'll never forget this statistic I heard once about how by 2040, if the numbers keep increasing at the same rate they are right now, that 100% of the United States budget is going to go to healthcare costs from preventable disease. And that's staggering. 2040, like, that's so close you can almost touch it. And 100% of the budget, there's going to be no money for anything else except for just going to treatment options for preventable disease. And we can stop those things now. You know, people don't need to be living with type 2 diabetes or heart disease and a lot of the mental health issues that we have now. So these doctors, they're going to fill you with a ton of information. These specialists are going to they're going to give you so much information and so much valuable information that we all need to know to recognize how we just fundamentally need to change our lives here in Canada, in the United States, because the way they're going right now is just not healthy for our bodies or for our minds. We're going to be talking to private facility owners. As we all know, private clubs are starting to be a little bit more mainstream than what big box gyms are. There's a ton of great, great private clubs, you know, from CrossFit gyms to spin to multi-use facilities, infrared yoga, all these places. And unless if you were around when that business started or you have a good connection with the owner, you probably don't know why that person started that club or what their motivation is or how they feel or the message they're trying to portray. So we want to get that out there for everybody to hear and to understand and build a better connection with their clubs. You know, not only to be able to give back to people in the community who are trying to affect change, you know, but there might be other things these club owners that are doing in your community that you might not be aware of that you want to be involved with that have nothing to do with fitness. So there'll be a voice for all of those people as well, to get a little bit more of their backstory. We're going to be talking to industry professionals in the nutrition field and in fitness. This will complement a lot of the interviews that we're going to be doing with general practitioners, specialists, and mental health specialists. So we're going to be talking to people who are strength and conditioning coaches, you know, some of the top spin instructors. We're going to be talking to nutritionists about different diets, mainstream diets, fad diets like, you know, keto, Mediterranean, carnivore, vegan, vegetarian. You know, what are the pros and cons of these diets? You know, what are some of the benefits that, you know, we can achieve in the short term and the long term? Just so people have a continuous resource to be able to go back to gain the information they need to live a healthier, more active life. And, you know, with the internet out there, we can do all the research we want, but sometimes it's hard to be able to dissect that information when it comes to fitness and nutrition, because there's all these quick fixes out there. And if anything, we've all realized now is, you know, there's no quick fix to health and wellness. It's a lifestyle. It's something we have to live every day. And the biggest thing is we all need the tools to be able to live that life. And weeding through the information can be mind-boggling to all of us who do it every day. You know, so we want to try and cut to the chase and, you know, give you the information and let you be the judge I also heard something once from this gentleman, you know, and he said, people, especially on their diet, set themselves up for failure because they think they're going to find one diet that's just going to be amazing for them. And that's how they're going to live the rest of their life, is eating this certain way and achieve success. And we know every other aspect of our life, there's nothing that we're going to do the same way every single day and not get bored of it and not going to want change and not going to deviate from that. So hopefully getting a little bit more perspective for everybody and how diets should change. You want them to change and it should never be the same. Depending on what you're doing in that day, that week, that month, that year, you're going to have a diet that, you know, mimics your success, and then finding something that is just truly sustainable. Something that's going to be sustainable in the long term and not just for the gains you want, whether it's performance or weight loss or strength gain. Something that's going to be sustainable that you can look back and it's easier to maintain and it's easier to be able to make that shift. The most important part of this podcast, outside of just information and education, is going to be talking to people that I coin to be homegrown athletes or homegrown warriors. So I know homegrown athletes and homegrown warriors seems like it's such a powerful and impactful term, you know, athlete, warrior. But really, it's essentially what we all are. You know, no matter whether or not you're in the health and fitness field or you're not, or you're going to the gym or you're not, you know, we're all just getting it done, and we're getting it done in different ways. So, you know, when I say homegrown athletes and I say homegrown warriors, I want people to think outside the box and realize that has nothing to do with just health and fitness. You know, you can be getting it done because you're waking up an hour early to be able to finish a project, or, you know, you're staying up late to be able to read kids' stories, or, you know, you're delivering pizza at night to be able to take the family out for dinner once a month, or, you know, whatever it is, no matter which way that you're crushing life, we're all crushing life in a certain way. And that's the thing that a lot of people, I believe, discredit themselves for, because, you know, it goes back to the concept, if we put an individual on a pedestal, you know, then we not only do we always have to leverage that singular person, you know, but if we don't feel like we're achieving that same thing, we feel like a failure, you know. But that's where, for me, I leverage so many different sources for motivation that I never really feel like I'm failing at anything, because I'm not scared to step outside of that box and just talk to people and find different motivation in different areas. And I think a lot of people do an amazing job every single day at crushing different aspects of life. And I feel like that's truly long-term sustainable for me to be successful in my life. But when I share these stories with other people, I see how that same concept transfers to them too, and how it seems overall more motivating. So, again, I also heard a quote one time, you know, that motivation is for a singular moment at a singular time, you know, but inspiration lasts a lifetime. And that's the core value of this podcast, is, you know, finding inspiration, you know, something that we can come back to repeatedly that will change our lives. And that's going to be the inspiration, not the motivation just to wake up one morning and, you know, go for a workout, or, you know, do like a power day at work or anything along those lines. This is just overall life motivation and life change. So this is We Are I. This is the podcast. This is the introduction. And all of our podcasts are going to be between 1 hour and 2 hours in length. They're going to be available on YouTube, Podbean. We're going to do our little blurbs on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to let everybody know when the new episodes are out. It's going to have a ton of exciting material. We're going to be posting workouts every single day, you know, for people to be able to have a resource to go to for a workout if they don't have one of their own, or if they just want to follow along with the schedule. We're also going to be challenging everybody to a consecutive day challenge, and realizing that, you know, before, when we had a lot more natural physical activity in our lives, we might have been able to get away with working out 3 or 4 days a week or doing something physically active 3 or 4 days a week. But, you know, with the more sedentary our lives get and the more technology plays a dominant role in our life, you know, we need to do that 60 minutes of activity, you know, 7 days a week. But we want to refine that down, that 60 day or 60 minutes a day, 7 days a week, to just something every day. You know, it can be 25 push-ups, it can be one static wall squat, it can be a 10 kilometer run, it can be anything in between. But the key principle to really take away from what the consecutive day challenge is just making it a priority every day to not only prioritize your health and wellness, but to be able to prioritize yourself. And this is going to be the thing that I think really is going to change the way people look at health and fitness, is that it doesn't have to be at a 45-minute class. It doesn't need to be a 60-minute workout at a gym. It doesn't need to be lacing up the runners to be able to go for a run in the rain when you don't want to go. You know, those days are going to come. Those days are going to be inevitable too, and we're going to have them, and that's great. You know, but how easy is it just to do, you know, 10 walking lunges or, you know, 10 jumping jacks three times? And just prioritizing it every day and doing something every day, even if it only takes 5 minutes, that's going to be the key to success. And that's where we're going to get the true benefit in just making that overall cultural shift. So again, lots of exciting news coming out, lots of exciting things happening at WRI. So stay tuned, keep updated on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you know, check us out, make sure that you're up on all the latest podcasts and episodes. And if you guys have any requests of things you want to know more about, you know, like cold shock proteins, heat shock proteins, a little bit more about the keto diet, you know, a little bit more about trunk stabilization exercises, or, you know, different kinds of motivation in life, let us know. You know, hit us up on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and let us know what you want to hear, and we'll track the people down to be able to give you the best information. So again, welcome to WRI.